afternoon everyone. Today I am going to discuss about the computer networks unit 1, that is transmission medium. In previous class we have discussed about this transmission medium. So in the transmission medium, how many types we are having? Guided and unguided. How many types we are having? Guided and unguided. So in the transmission medium, so this is the diagram we are having. In the transmission we are having guided medium and media and unguided media. Guided media comes under the wide network, and unguided media comes under the wireless network. In previous class we discussed about the guided wide, that is called the transmission mediums having the two types, that is guided wide and unguided wide. In last previous class we have discussed about the guided wide gurinchi manamu discuss chestam. So in this, how many types we are having? Twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable. So these three types we have discussed in previous class. Now I am going to discuss about the unguided media, that is called wireless. So whatever the twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable, what we are using, those all the different materials we are using in the wide network. So in the unguided media, we are using the wireless through air or space, free space, we are going to maintain the communication between the sender and the receiver. Okay ma? So now coming to the unguided media, that is wireless. So these things all we have discussed in the previous class ma. Now I am going to unguided media. So this is the unguided media ma. So in this unguided media, what is mean by unguided media ma? The unguided media transport electromagnetic waves. The unguided media transport electromagnetic waves without using a physical conductor, without using a physical conductor. So what is mean by unguided media? Unguided media transport electromagnetic waves without using physical conductor. So we doesn't use any physical conductor in order to transport the electromagnetic waves. So that is called the unguided media. It is a wireless, and this type of communication is referred as wireless communication. So ee type of communication ni em antaramo wireless communication ani cheptamo. So wireless communication uses the electromagnetic spectrum. So whatever the wireless communication we are using, that uses the electromagnetic spectrum ranging from 3 kilohertz to 900 terahertz. So this is the range of the electromagnetic spectrum. So this type of communication, we can say it is a wireless communication. The signals are normally broadcast through the free space. So signals can be ela move avutayi ma, mana signals anedi from air dwara move avutayi, free space, and available anyone who has devices capable of receiving them. The signals are normally broadcasted through the free space and available to anyone who has device capable of receiving them. So this is called the wireless communication. So what is mean by wireless communication ma? In the wireless communication, we are going to communicate through the signals or normally broadcast through the free space. Ante ma, manaki manam use chese unguided media anedi wireless dwara communication ane jarugutundi. So wireless ante enti? Through signals, through free space lo manam communication anedi occur avutam. So indulo manam electromagnetic physical conductors anedi emi use cheyemu, only electromagnetic waves dwara manam transport chestam information anedi. So that is called the wireless communication. So okay na? So in this we are having the one figure. This is the small image. In this image, the part of the electromagnetic spectrum, the part of the electromagnetic spectrum that ranges entha range ma, a range 300 gigahertz nunchi 900 terahertz anamata. So that is uses the one part of 300 nunchi 400 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. We are use the infrared, and at 400 to 900 terahertz we use the light waves. Okay na, light waves. So unguided signals, whatever we are using, in this unguided signals can travel from source to destination in several ways. So whatever the unguided signals we are using, So the signals can be moved from source to destination in several ways. Okay, now so this is the different ways we are presented here. So this is first one is a ground propagation, second one is a sky propagation, and third one is a line of sight propagation. Line of sight propagation. Okay, so these are the three types of propagations we are having in the unguided signals from source to destination. Okay, so this is the diagram of this. So this diagram is the electromagnetic. This diagram is a electromagnetic spectrum for wireless communication. Okay, so now I'm going to discuss about this travels. The signals travels from source to destination in several ways. We are saying so ground propagation. So ground propagation, sky propagation, line of sight propagation. See, these are the different propagations we are having in order to travel the data signals from source to destination. Okay, so in this we see this is the ionosphere. This is called the ionosphere. So we having some explanation about this. So in the ground propagation, radio waves travel through the lowest portion. So in the ground propagation, this is the first image is a ground propagation. So in ground propagation lo em jarugutundi, so in the ground propagation, radio waves travels from the radio waves travels through the lowest portion of the atmosphere that hugging the earth. So ground propagation ante enti mana travel chesina radio waves anedi ela travel avutai lower portion of the earth yokka lower portion nunchi mana waves anedi travel avutai ante earth ki closed ga attach ayi aa waves anedi velthai. So dani em antam ground propagation antam. So the signals will be wo the signals are radio waves that will be move in the lowest portion of the earth surface, earth in the atmosphere hugging the earth. So this low frequency signals in all directions emanate in all directions from the transmitting antenna and follow the curvature of the planet. So distance depends on the amount of power. The distance depend on the amount of power in the signal. So this is the ground propagation. So what is that? The radio waves travels through the lowest portion of the atmosphere and it is hugging to the earth. So these low frequency signals emanate in all directions from transmitting antenna and follow the curvature of the planet. So whatever the distance we are taking from the signal, so that signal is depends on the amount of power. The distance depends on the amount of power in the signal. The greater the power, the greater the distance. It is greater the power and greater the signal. So this is called the ground propagation. Okay, next coming to the sky propagation. So what is mean by sky propagation? So in this sky propagation we are having the high frequency. So in the sky propagation we are having the high frequency radio waves that radiate upward into the ionosphere where they are reflected back to the earth. So ground, in the ground propagation, the radio waves travels through the lowest portion of the atmosphere, and the sky propagation, the frequency is higher radio waves that move upward in the ionosphere where they are reflected back to the earth. This type of transmission is greater distance with lower output power. So this is called the sky propagation. So next coming to the third one, that is line of sight propagation. So it having the very high frequency signals that are transmitted in a straight line directly from antenna to antenna. So in this antenna we have directional facing each other and either tall enough or close enough together not to be affected by the curvature of the earth. So these are the three types of propagation modes we are having in the unguided media, that is a wireless communication. So next coming to the wireless communication, we are having three types. One is radio waves, microwaves and infrared. Okay, coming to the radio waves. So what is mean by radio waves? So there is no clear limit distinctions between radio waves and microwaves. So the electromagnetic waves ranging in frequency between 3 kilohertz and 1 gigahertz are normally called radio waves. Okay, so the radio waves are mainly used. So why we are using the radio waves? Mainly used for multicast trans communication. So the radio waves mainly used for multicast communication, such as radio and television and paging systems. So these are the different examples of the multicast communications. So why we are using the radio waves, ma? For using the multicast communication, such as radio, television and paging systems. So they are having the high regulated. They are very high regulated. So this means the radio waves having the omnidirectional. When an antenna transmits radio waves, they are propagated in all directions. This means that all the sending and receiving antennas do not have to be aligned. A sending antenna sends waves that can be received by the receiving antenna. So in the omnidirectional property has the disadvantages. So that is, the radio waves transmitted by one antenna are susceptible to the interference by the another antenna that may send signals using the same frequency or band. So this is called the radio waves. So the behavior of the waves rather than the frequency is better in criteria for classifications. So this is called the radio waves. So next, what, ma? Next, what is mean by omnidirectional antenna? So what is mean by omnidirectional antenna? So in this antenna, this is the antenna we are having. This is the diagram of the omnidirectional antenna. So in this, the radio waves uses the omnidirectional antennas that sends out signals in all directions. So the signals will be sent in all directions based on the wavelength, strength and the purpose of transmission. So the radio waves is a omnidirectional antennas. The whatever the signals we are having, the signals will be sent in all directions based on the wavelength, strength and the purpose of transmission. We can have several types of antennas. So in the omnidirectional antenna, so manaki so many types of antennas unnai. So we have some application about this antenna. So the omnidirectional characteristics of radio waves make them useful for multicasting, in which there is one sender but many receivers. We having one sender and many receivers. So coming to the applications, ma, what is the applications of the omnidirectional antenna? So in omnidirectional characteristics, we having the radio mix that make them useful for multicasting. So there is one sender but many receivers. We having one sender and many receivers. So the FM radio band goes from 88 to 108 megahertz. That is the example of the omnidirectional. Televisions and radio are the examples of the multicasting. So these are the applications of the omnidirectional antenna. Next, coming to microwaves. So what is mean by microwaves? In electromagnetic waves having frequency between 1 and 300 gigahertz are called the microwaves. So what is the range of the microwaves, ma? The electromagnetic waves having the frequency between 1 and 300 gigahertz are called the microwaves. So microwaves are unidirectional. It is a unidirectional. When an antenna transmits microwaves, they can only narrowly focused. This means that sending and receiving the antennas need to be aligned. The unidirectional property has an obvious advantages. So this is the, see, this is the micro, in the microwaves we are using the unicast communication as a cellular phones, satellite networks and wireless LANs, wireless local area network. So it having the high frequency ranges, cannot be penetrate walls. Okay, by using the directional antennas, point to point line of sight communication. So what is the microwaves, ma? Microwaves means what, ma? We are using the electromagnetic waves having the frequency between 1 and 300 gigahertz microwaves. Okay, so in the microwaves we are using the unicast communication with cellular telephones, satellites, networks and wireless LANs. So the antenna transmit microwaves, they can be narrowly focused. This means sending and receiving the antenna need to be aligned. So the property, and these are the advantages of the unidirectional. The pair of antennas can be aligned without interfering with another pair of aligned antennas. We having some characteristics about this microwave propagation. So the microwave propagation is line of sight. Since the towers with the mounted antennas need to be direct sight of each other, that is towers that are far part of need to be very tall. The curvature of the earth as well as the other blocking obstacles does not allow two short towers to communicate by using microwaves. The repeaters or phon allowed need to long distance communication. So in these microwaves we are having relatively wide band, that is 299 gigahertz. It provides the higher data rate rather than data rate provided by the radio wave band. So this is the main characteristics of the microwave propagations. So this is the unidirectional antenna. This diagram is the unidirectional antenna. We are having two diagrams here. One is dish antenna, another is horn antenna. So microwaves need unidirectional antennas that send out signals in one direction. So in the unidirectional antenna, so whatever the signals we are sending in one direction, the microwaves need the antenna that send, that uses the parabolic dish and horn. Okay, horn. These are the two example diagrams we are having in the unidirectional antenna. So next, coming to applications. So applications of the unidirectional. So microwaves, due to their unidirectional properties, are very useful when unicast, that is one-to-one communication, is needed between the sender and the receiver. The cellular phones and wireless LANs are the examples of the applications of microwave signals. Third one is the infrared. So in what is mean by infrared? Infrared waves. So with the frequency from 300 gigahertz to 4 terahertz can be used for short range communication. So in this infrared waves, we are having the high frequency that cannot be penetrate walls. So this advantages characteristics prevents the interface between one system and another. A short range communication system is one room cannot be affected by another system in the next room. So when we use our infrared remote control, we do not interfere with the use of the remote by our neighbors. So this is the characteristics make infrared signals useless for long range communication. So we cannot use the infrared waves outside the building because the sun's rays cannot, infrared waves that can interfere with the communication. So this is called the infrared. So in the infrared we having different signals, sorry, different applications. So in the infrared band, almost 400 terahertz, which has excellent potential for data transmission, such as wide bandwidth, can be used to transmit digital data with a very high data rate. The Infrared Data Association sponsoring the use of infrared waves to establish the standards. We are using the signals for communication between devices such as keyboards, mic, PCs and mic printers. Examples, some of the manufacturers provide a special port called Infrared Data Association port that allows a wireless keyboard to communicate with PCs. Infrared signals define the Infrared Data Association transmit through line of the sight. So in this port, keyboard needs to point to the personal computers for transmission can be occur. So these are the applications of the infrared waves. So next, coming to this is the infrared map. So in the first presentation we having the diagram about the infrared. So this is the infrared diagram. So in this infrared diagram, so if you see this diagram in the unguided media, so the radio waves and microwaves we are having, so 3 kHz to 900 terahertz. So 300 to 300 gigahertz is covered by the radio wave and microwave, and 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz is covered by the infrared, and 400 to 900 terahertz is covered the light wave. So whatever the communications we are providing, that is the wireless. So in the guide media we are using the wide network. So in this we are using different materials, that is twisted paired cable, coaxial cable and fiber optic cable. So these are the comes under the guided, that is called wide network. So now we have discussed about the unguided media. So this is the unguided media. In this unguided media we are using the wireless, which is communicated through the free space. So okay, so we can say it is a wireless communication. So for providing the communication between one sender to the receiver, we are using the different waves, different waves in the air. That is, what is that waves? Radio waves, microwave, infrared wave. So in the wireless transmission we are using different types of waves, that is radio wave, microwave and infrared wave. So through this radio wave, microwave and infrared wave, we are going to transmit the data through the signal. Okay, so this is the unguided media. So in this we are having different, in the radio waves, infrared waves and microwaves, we are using the different frequency ranges. So in the radio waves we are using the 3 kHz and 1 GHz for radio waves. That is the range of the electromagnetic waves in the radio wave. So the it is mainly used for radio waves. Why we are using for multicast communication. So multicast communication purposes we are going to use the radio waves. So in this we are using the antennas, that is omnidirectional. In the radio waves we are using the omnidirectional antennas. So the antenna transmit the radio waves and propagate in all directions, So this is the antenna we are having. So in this antenna, sending antenna sends the waves and receiving by any receiving antenna in this figure. So the radio waves are propagated in the sky mode and it can be traveling a long distance. So this is called the radio wave. Microwaves means this frequency range is, the electromagnetic frequency range is between 1 and 300 gigahertz, all called the microwaves. So it is the direction, what is the direction of these microwaves? Unicast communication. It is the unicast communication. So that is cellular phones, satellite networks and wireless LANs. So these are the microwaves which is communicated in different waves. Higher frequency ranges cannot be penetrate the walls. When you are using the directional antennas, the point to point line of the site communication will be occurred. So in the microwaves, the band will be relatively wide, that is almost 299 gigahertz. That can be having the high data rate. The high data rate will be possible in the microwaves. So next, this is the unidirectional antenna. So it is mainly focused in one direction. So it will be mainly in, this is parabolic dish. This is a parabolic dish, and the wave will be the direction of the communication in one wave. Okay, now the antennas will focus in one side, one direction. Okay, so this is the dish antenna, this is the horn antenna. So okay, and next coming to this is the infrared ma. So infrared. Hello. Who is talking?
Srikant.
Hello.
I am Srikant.
What ma? What you want? Hello.
Neither call this.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Who is talking ma?
I am Srikant.
Why are you talking in the middle of the class? Okay, ma, listen. So infrared rays, So in the infrared waves, we are having the frequency range that is 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. So when we are using the short range communication, the closed area using the line of sight propagation. So okay, na? So this is the remote control. The infrared rays is a remote control. So we do not use any interface with the use of remote by the neighbors. Okay. So this is the infrared rays. So this is the unguided transmission medium. So in the next class, we will discuss about the next topic, that is error detection. Okay. So in the next class, we will discuss about the error detection and correction and types of errors. So this is the next topic we'll discuss in the next class.